plan on tree protection.
Oh, okay.
So we're in Lake Lanier, we're going to go out and then we're going to go.
Nydia, I was at the museum last week in D.C. I told them that if they didn't know what a Nydia was, they were going to be finding out.
Lynch the bear.
That's great, Jack. Thanks.
Hey, is it okay?
See that bench right there? Yeah. Sit in that bench.
I was just trying to figure out who did this.
Good to see you there.
Who put this together?
I'm not sure what it is, so I don't know if I get credit.
Well, it says more information than about Forsyth.com, Facebook group, focus
awesome
on Forsyth.
Oh, yes, there's a lot of information on about Forsyth.com.
This is a boycott. It's a boycott of the City of Cumming restaurants.
Oh, yes.
Okay, so I just didn't know who was distributing that. Somebody, there's some folks behind you that would like to come up.
There was a bunch of them underneath the windshields up towards the area up at Marketplace is where I'd seen
that. That's what I was there this morning, but I wasn't putting these out. I was putting those out.
Wow.
We buy 14 million gallons a day of raw water, and then depending on the need,
in the wintertime, we don't really need a lot more than that. But in the summertime, we can use up to like 22, 23 million gallons a day. So that additional above 14 million, they have to buy. So the city sells 14 million gallons a day of raw water that we treat ourselves over that.
See the cloud? Get that big cloud. It's the mayor.
That's about they've just completed an expansion of that plant. They're going to treat 26 million gallons a day, which is more treated water than the county ever used in the past. We've never used that much in any single day. So once they've done that, we can do all of our own water. We still have to rely on the city.
It could have been a majority.
In the lake.
We couldn't see.
The $2.50 that he's going to charge us is a complete increase because you got to back out the 52 pennies. But it's still five, six, seven, eight, ten times as much. Maybe not 25 times as much, but it's still a huge increase that's going to hit every one of your water bills. So your water bills are going to go up significantly. The city owns all of the infrastructure from the lake all the way to the city treatment plant, and it owns the pipe up to where it breaks off to go to the county treatment plant.
What? Can't we go as a county and try to take over from the city?
I think I read the question. Does the city pipe go across county property? Do you know that?
Do they have an easement across county land? They do. You said they have to.
I don't know the answer to that. I know the pipe goes in over at Mary Alice Lake, Mary Alice Park, where it goes in. That's city property. So it's entirely possible that everything from Mary Alice Park back over to here is city property.
But yeah, that's not really.
I'm doing very well.
They control all the pumps. So it's not like the county can say, well, you're not going to take our water, we're just going to pump our water. Because the city controls those pumps and they can direct the water wherever they want it to go. So if they want to turn off all water going to our treatment plant, they can do it. They can absolutely do it.
So where is our attorney? Where are our elected officials?
Well, our attorney really doesn't have much to say about it because ultimately it's up to the county commissioner to negotiate off what they call an intergovernmental agreement between the city and the county. That agreement dictates the terms of how much more we're going to buy, how much we're going to pay for it, all that, whether it's a tree or something. All that is supposed to be in that intergovernmental agreement. Mr. Boff.
Yes, sir.
What good timing. Why don't you come on up here and tell these folks where we are. Those of you that don't know, this is Jim Boff, the chairman of the Board of Commissioners here in the county. So welcome.
Glad
you're here.
Thanks for being here.
Appreciate it.
Absolutely.
Thank you. I guess we're here talking about water.
We are.
We're the high cost level. I did not hear what you said, so I don't know if I'm stepping right on what you had said.
I was just telling them, given briefly what is about to happen if nothing changes between now and October the 1st, and the question was, well, where's the city, where's the county attorney, and where's the Board of Commissioners? Yeah. So timing was good.
Well, according to what the mayor said on October the 1st, he'll turn off the raw water, any raw water that the county gets, and will provide only finished water. If that happens October 1st, and October 1st historically is like other Octobers were, we will be short of water for the county. Now, short of water has a couple of implications. One, of course, is that possibly some people won't have water. The other is maybe not quite that drastic. People will have low pressure, possibly. If there's a fire, possibly there are fire hydrants which won't have the right amount of pressure. Another thing that happens is if he's going to provide us all of the finished water, if he were able to do that, which he can't because he doesn't have a permit to do it,
right?
He doesn't have a treatment plan to do it, and if you have those other two things, he doesn't have the pipe capacity to us to provide us that much water. So our assumption is that he would provide as much as he could, and that would increase either the flow rate or the pressure in the pipes, which would scour the pipes, can potentially damage them, but also, as you can imagine, over time, there's stuff that builds up in pipes. They could shake that loose and may discolor the water. You might be doing your laundry and all of a sudden your clothes come out red is the color that I'm told.
Yep.
And so that's the position we're currently in right now.
I understand about the fact that they sell us raw water at a certain rate, they sell us finished water at a certain rate, and that they're going to shut off the raw water. So I just want to make sure I understand. You've got the raw water that comes from the lake and then diverts over to the Antioch plant. And then you've got the rest of the raw water going to the Cumming water plant that gets treated. And you're saying that when it leaves the Cumming plant and back to Cumming, they don't have the capacity to return that water as it
needs.
So it isn't just that they're going to charge us the rate of the finished water. We just won't get as much water.
That's correct. Physically they can't do it, legally in terms of their permits they can't do it, and capacity wise they don't have a big enough plant to finish that much water if the demand for water is historically similar to what it has been in other Octobers. Now the demand for water falls off in the cooler months, so it's hard to know what all the effect will be in November, December, January, February, March, but back in the spring if we're still in this situation, the demand will pick up to the peak months, which is June, July, August, and then we will really be short. And that's even if we pay the vastly increased rates, this will continue unless some other arrangement is made.
And what are they hoping for? What standing do we have? Do we have anything we hold that we can use as a bargaining chip to get them to make it?
Well, I mean, I personally am in favor of getting seeking an injunction from the court telling them that they can't turn the water off. And why hasn't that happened? Right now, it takes a majority of the board of commissioners, of the five commissioners who can vote on this subject or on this issue of water between the city and the county right now. There are only four of us who can vote, but one of us is accused. And so far, the typical vote is a 2-2 vote. 2-2 is a tie on a vote. So on a tie vote, that's a defeat of the vote. So if the motion is to seek an injunction and it fails 2-2, or it ties 2-2, that's a failure of the vote. And just because you're being politically correct, I will let you know that the two commissioners that are voting against seeking an injunction are Patrick Bell and Brian Tam.
Okay.
Why is the one vote recused though? What's
Pete their Amos, Amos. Pete Amos owns a water company and buys water directly from the city and resells it to like four or five subdivisions. He's in District 1, which is basically the city. Yeah. He represents the city also.
If this were to be done, if the water being turned off were to be done by, let's say, the Middle Eastern Arab Land Development Corporation, we would probably call this a terrorist act, wouldn't we?
Well, I will say this, the mayor...
could very well be.
The mayor certainly wrote to the Corps of Engineers when they were seeking to rewrite their operations manual for the lake under the Judge Magnuson ruling, and in that letter, the mayor said, A, that to rewrite the manual would be reckless, and he said it would be a threat to the health, safety, and welfare of both Forsyth County and the city of Cummings. So, because rewriting that manual would have been a rewrite under Magnuson of providing no water for drinking out of the lake. So he saw it that way under those circumstances, and I can't speak for him as to why he doesn't see it that way under these circumstances.
If you had a different vote from the county commissioners, how much time do you need to make an injunction effective?
Well,
right down to the deadline?
It depends on several things. First of all, if you have an injunction, someone has to write up the legalness of the injunction. You just don't send a letter or a telex or a email over. So, you know, I don't know how long, let's say that takes at least a couple of days. So the county attorney would have to be told you have authority or direction from the board to do that. Then you have to get it on the court schedule or the court docket. And that's also a little bit of an unknown time frame. I would think that the courts would see that as very important.
An emergency.
and put it right up there. But we also expect that local judges here, we would guess, would recuse themselves, and so they'd have to check the schedule of somebody outside the county to come and be the judge for the for the injunction.
That's negative. That's very negative.
Wow.
That means we're in bad shape.
Yeah.
So do we need to send letters or emails or whatever to Patrick Bell and Brian Tam?
I got the phone and call them.
Is that the best thing to do?
Emails, you have a written record of it.
That's true.
Something that people need to think about
TAM, right?
Is who here lives in District 1?
I guess I do.
Okay, you know where you get your water from? From the city. It's not going to affect you.
Not going to affect you at all.
Who lives in District 3? Okay, well, District 3, you get a lot of your water from the city. It's not going to affect you. District 5, how many in District 5? What half or more of your water comes from the city, it's not going to affect you. What two districts are going to be most affected by the cutoff of water or an increase in water rates?
Two and four.
And who represents 2 and 4?
Brian and Patrick.
Who's not representing their constituents?
Isn't that amazing?
That is amazing.
Well, you also have to consider that Brian Tam has a lease for his restaurant with the city of Cumming. Okay,
yeah.
So he's not going to do anything that's going to upset the
the balance for his lease. So.
Yeah, he's got a great deal on the lease.
Oh, it's an outstanding deal.
Okay, but actually, he doesn't have that. It's in his wife's name, Brian. Well, totally divorced from it. So,
that's a technical.
Yeah, right.
Except he gets his income. Leave that.
It's in a new LLC called Schoolhouse Holdings LLC. It's not his wife personally. It's in a corporate entity.
Which has not paid their registration dues for this year, correct?
Indeed, yes, sir.
Ron.
Jim, now, you know, I just strongly feel the mayor's not going to turn this off October 1st because you can't just discard the health of people that live in District 2 and 4 and those of us in 5 that are on county water. So something's going to happen. I mean, the mayor, in my take, is going to back down. He's going to come along with some kind of a compromise that does give him a lot of revenue that he doesn't deserve, but is going to look better than shutting off the water on October 1st. Right. And Tam and Bell are going to try to be the heroes by saying, look, we helped avoid this catastrophe that was fostered on the county. Okay? Now, you mentioned some kind of write up an injunction. I assume that also takes 3 votes from the Board of Commissioners to get that started.
Sure.
Otherwise, I would say, why don't we get that started now and have it ready to go? Right? Yes.
I think direction from the chairman could direct the county attorney to
get started?
Prepare a contingency.
See, if you can do that, it seems to me like we ought to get that going now and have it ready to go in case we do face this deadline. Although I don't in any stretch of the imagination think that the mayor's going to turn the water off. But he is going to play it. He's also going to play it into the local off the sales tax negotiations that are going on right now. He's going to try to work. I'm going to give you this deal on water if you give me 15% of the local off the sales tax where he deserves 3 or 4, okay?
That's right.
So we just have to strategize, it seems to me, around those situations.
Well, and so to the degree we're talking now about loss, there will be all 5 commissioners at this point who will vote on that.
And we know it's 3 of 5, 3 of 2.
So it was only refused on that?
Right, it's only refused on water.
Hear it better over here.
Okay.
Sadly enough, we know it's going to be 3 of 2. I mean, it's just like throwing the 3 of 2 on the most often sales tax in favor of the
It only affects the 2 districts as far as the amount of pressure or whatever, as you were saying, but doesn't it affect us all as if we're in county and not in the city? Even if the city gives us the water, don't our rates go up?
Oh, okay.
Isn't the cost
what Charlie said is true. It's not quite as clear as he made it sound. You can be in any district probably and potentially on county water.
Right.
He said generally or the majority in some of the districts. So if you're on county water and the rates go up, the rates will have to go up.
Right.
The city has at least, call it 3 tiers. If you live inside the city limits, you pay the least for your water.
Right.
I live Buford Dam Road. I pay a little bit more, but I pay less than people in the on county water. People on the county pay the most. So in other words, my way of seeing it is that county people are subsidizing people who live in the city or just outside the city.
I agree. Instead of us all paying the share of the cost evenly.
Instead of us all getting the lowest cost possible.
Right. Well, I would say whether it affected me directly or not, it ought to be fair for everybody. And I would stand up for a district, whether it's mine or not. If it's not going to affect them fairly, then I'd stand up for them.
Well, I think what, you know, most people think is, why should it cost essentially any more than it takes to deliver it, and maybe pay bonds if you have bonds and pay the employees? Why should it cost anybody significantly more than that? It's state water that has fallen into a federally impounded structure.
Right.
And therefore it belongs to, quote unquote, the people. And other than having your own expenses for it be covered, I'm not sure why it should be more than that. Yes, sir.
In the 1987 agreement that was signed with the city, between the city and the county, included a large percentage of the special purpose local option sales tax at that time to go to the city water system. I think it was like 37%. The county has made that investment in the water system. Later on, when there was a withdrawal taken from the lake, the county paid part of that withdrawal cost. And in addition, the county's been paying high water rates all these years. So the county has had a big investment in the city water system that supports your argument, I think, that says that we shouldn't be paying much more than what it costs to deliver the water to the county, because we've made the investments along with the city.
And I don't disagree with the word you said. That'd be great to perhaps be able to tell to a reasonable person or a judge. However, being short of a reasonable person, that leaves a judge, and without a majority of the board, we'll never see a judge to say those
words. I understand that, but I think the people, as much as we can, we got to get the word out to the people besides come. I mean, the mayor will say, this is our system, we've made the investment, therefore we can charge you whatever we want, right? And by the way, we're charging one of the lowest rates of any of the counties around. I mean, that's his story. We've made investments in that, his story doesn't hold up, even if it was reasonable. Okay.
So let's see a letter to the editor, exactly what you said on Wednesday's paper.
Be a good idea.
Write it.
They don't take my letter. They won't publish this letter.
They won't?
No.
Who's they?
Well, okay, then I guess I'll have to do some
I was actually very surprised that I got an article in there this week.
What, if anything, if they were talking to media, long range, what, if anything, is happening to facilitate to get rid of this garbage?
Well, maybe I'll try it.
Dependency, you mean?
They call me.
That's our own
intake.
Right. Long term, we need our own intake.
No more life for you.
The county has been asking for our own intake for years. These two gentlemen know more historically about that from the EPD and the Corps of Engineers, and we have always been denied. We actually have, and just let me finish one more thing. In addition to the lake, we currently have an application to the EPD to take water out of the Chattahoochee River south of the dam. We've had that for a number of years. They've told us for a number of years they're in favor of approving it, and yet they don't approve it. And I can't really tell you why, other than the EPD is part of the problem here, in that the city of Cumming has a permit to withdraw more water for, call it 5,000 people, than we have to withdraw for now 175,000 people. So the EPD, by not doing a reasonable regulation of the need to the entities that can draw water, has not served us well. And we have, I believe the county's made good faith efforts all these years in order to get these things increased and to get water out of the Chattahoochee, and yet we don't. We just don't. It's like getting a driver's license. You either get one or you don't get one, and we don't get one. Ron.
Jim, it's been that way back when I was on the board. EPD refuses a permit to withdraw water from Lake Lanier. And my impression at the time is that the mayor had a lot of influence on EPD. The director of EPD at the time, Harrell told me that you've got a contract with the city to buy water from them. My reaction was, that's none of your business. That's not EPD's business, that's between the city and the county. We then went to King and Spaulding and hired King and Spaulding to take legal action against EPD. Shortly thereafter, EPD decided they would give the county a permit to withdraw. Then we subsequently got tied up in this tri-state water war where no one could get additional water. So that cut that off. But I'm just telling you, before we had to hire King and Spaulding, I think it was Pat Barmeyer was our attorney from King and Spaulding, and we may have to do the same thing again.
Again, you need the votes to do that, though.
Right, yes, now, you need the votes. I agree
without,
with that.
Without Bell and Tam on board, that...
I understand all that, Hal, but my point is that the more we can get the information out to the folks, like you're trying to do today,
right,
the more we will get pressure on the commissioners who are not representing the county.
And the other thing that we can hope for is that, you know, things don't completely fall apart between now and January, because I think when Bell is gone, I think maybe Cindy Mills is going to be a vote for the county. I can't obviously guarantee that. I can't get it out of her head, but I believe Cindy will vote in favor of doing what's right for the county as opposed to doing what's right for the city.
And that may well be right, but I would just encourage us to move forward and take.
Oh, we should be doing everything.
Every action we can right now.
Totally agree.
And shame these other commissioners who are not representing the folks that.
But they're shameless. I mean, they are. They are shameless. They cannot be shamed is the problem.
They're giving pressure right now from the city and the supporters that the city lines up for. If we get the other folks as much involved, maybe they'll pay more attention.
And Brian Tam was just reelected. I mean, he's feeling quite emboldened.
I don't know why, but he was.
Here's one of the things that, you know, you really need to consider. And it's something that Jim and I have talked about this a little bit. Ron, you probably, you know, may have a different opinion on it. But, you know, now is the time to start talking to, I hate to say Jack Murphy for all it's worth, which isn't a whole lot. You know, but, you know, our local representatives, we need to be talking to the governor, sending him letters, because what he's got to realize, this is a Republican, you know, county. You know, if this county were to lose its water, you know, because of an inaction on behalf of Nathan Deal and Casey Cagle and some of the legislative leaders from this county, you know, I'd hate to think that, you know, we put Democrats back in office, but, you know, maybe we might put a few Tea Party and some Libertarians in their place. Somebody who might actually listen, you know, to the citizens of the county and not pay attention to that 25 people in this county that tend to control the activities. I mean, it's, you know, it's kind of a, Jim's talked to the governor. I mean, I haven't talked to Nathan, but I did deal with Sonny. And we've all talked to EPD, and you know, it's just a thing of wind isn't blowing because it goes in one ear and comes out the other. It's amazing if you light a cigarette, see the smoke pass through. but I mean, you know, the thing about this is, you know, we've got to get beyond Brian Tam and Patrick Bell, because, you know, we've really got to get it to a higher level. Because I honestly, yeah, I would rather see the mayor go ahead and shut the water off, because I think that would be the best thing that could happen for this county.
Amen.
Because, you know, then, and I said, that's kind of up to Jim and Todd Levent to resist.
He knows that.
Well, I know that. But to resist efforts to deal with this amazing compromise, you know, plan that they're going to come up with. No, let's let it go the full nine yards. You know, let's let it end up in court. And it's got to. I mean, whether they'll take action or not, I feel fairly certain that the state and its on its own behalf would take action, because they're not going to let 173,000 Republicans go without water to satisfy, you know, a few diehard Democrats.
If your water bill says Forsyth County water, then are you? Because I'm District 5, but I pay my bill to Forsyth County. So I'm on.
My bill, I don't live in the city, but my letterhead on my bill says City of Cumming or
okay.
City Water Service.
So I'm one of the, like our neighborhood's one of the ones that's.
That's correct.
And I live out in the western end of the county, and I'm in the city service area, so I pay my bill from the city.
So does the Board of Commissioner have anything planned in the next 2 weeks? We have on the agenda for next Thursday night, Todd Levent and I put it on the agenda in open session, not executive session, in open session. At this point, it remains to have a vote as to whether to move for an injunction to stop the city from turning off the water. Thursday. And we'll see what the vote is then. That'll be a vote taken in public, not behind closed doors like an executive session.
So you can do that?
Because we put it on the agenda, yes. Now it can also be removed.
When's that?
It can be postponed. Thursday.
What time?
5 o'clock.
Right there?
Yeah, right there. Right in that building right there.
At 5:30.
Yes, it should be at 5 o'clock.
That can change at any time.
5 o'clock. What's the best thing for all of us to do?
I think we should be sending emails and letters to, you know, any the head of the EPD,
the mayor, the governor, Mark Hamill, commissioners that you disagree, you think to disagree with their position. Mike Dudgeon, Mark, newspapers,
Mark Hamilton.
I will say this, Mike Dudgeon, to me, you know, in I'll call him private phone calls, and he's actually written some things in the newspaper. Mike Dudgeon definitely seems to have the most sympathy for the idea that people should have to pay any more for a commodity like water, which belongs to the state. He definitely gets all over him, you know. And at one time, jokingly, I said, well, what if the county's charging too much for water? And he said, you're not supposed to be doing that either. And I don't think the county is. I'm just, as a joke, said that. He said, I don't want anybody charging too much for water.
He did write an article on it.
Yes, he did.
One of the things that I thought was very good, because he was talking about the two getting together and logically approaching this thing and coming to a compromise that made sense and didn't give anybody the advantage.
That's correct. And my personal opinion is I don't want to take advantage. If we're using infrastructure, if we're using water that has costs associated with it, employee costs, intake costs, costs for access to something, chemicals to treat the thing, new plants, et cetera,
sure.
Then the county or whoever's on using that resource ought to pay their weight, or pay their freight, I should say. It's just paying above that that's a problem for me.
I agree.
The city and the county should all pay the same rate thing based on what you said. Every person in the city and the county.
As close to possible. You know, you have to realize that some people live further away and it costs more to actually distribute the water the further you can away from
not,
the plant.
Not once you get the infrastructure there, it doesn't cost any more to send it through. And we've already paid for that.
And that also depends, but I can't say absolutely to the penny everybody pays exactly the same thing, but it ought to be much closer than it is. And certainly, under all circumstances, nobody ought to be subsidizing a low bill for somebody else.
Can you talk about duplication of services and consolidation? I mean, after all, we have essentially two billing departments. You have two department heads over water.
Well, I mean, yeah, on the one hand, the problem is we've got one intake. So we're sort of lacking one duplication of service. It'd be better if we had two. But, you know, as it is now, there's one for the city, one for the county, and same thing for sewer, which is not really part of this. But, you know, I just like to see the value for what I'm paying. And if there's duplicate service and one service is not superior to another or necessary for some other reason, I don't. It's hard for me to see the value.
You know, if you took the total revenue for the city of Cumming, how much is the water worth to them? If I thought a percentage basis.
Well, I don't have a hard answer for that. They take in, I think, between $4 and $5 million a year in water.
Going to be a big hit to
them. Well, it would, except, you know, then here comes the following issues. The mayor says he has no debt. None. He says that he spent $35 million on a new sewer treatment plant a couple of years ago. Still no debt. He says he spent $17 to $18 million on the water intake. Still no debt. He wants us to pay around $11 to $12 million for our share of the new water intake, which would be, you know, money that he has coming in, plus the $4 to $5 million in revenue for water a year, plus money for the SPLOST, a percentage of the SPLOST, plus percentage for the loss. But I can't know for sure, but I would guess that he's got $15-20 million in the bank. Well, that's great, good for him. But he's got the money in the bank because the county goes in debt for its water service.
Well, and because he's been getting a disproportionate share of the lost and the splost and this water revenue. I mean, as you're pointing out, no debt and no city property tax.
Yeah,
so where is he getting the money?
He's getting it all from
all
services,
from the county.
From the county.
Wow.
I agree with this man over here. I mean, let him do it. Instead of 24 people here, you'll have thousands of people here.
Well, so if they turn on their tap and they get brown water, they just run out of pressure in their water
show
hose.
Show up to the meeting.
If I knew they would all not come to me, I would be a lot better.
Right.
I want to, a lot of people have different ideas, just take the water, just do this, just do that. You know, from my point of view, I have to try to act as in good faith as I possibly can.
I just think from a bargaining standpoint, what these gentlemen here have been saying, all this other stuff that's going to get into the works, if they cut the water off, then we'd be in a better position to get something done.
That's their decision,
They'll never let it happen.
I think Ron was right when he said that what will happen is at the 11th hour, there will be a miraculous save, you know, angels in the outfield, you know, will appear to two commissioners, and they'll come forth with a miraculous plan that will cost the citizens of the county, you know, some additional amount of money, probably more in debt to the city, but it will get us out of this, you know, this morass that, you know, Jim and Ron and myself have put us in over the years by, you know, not getting down and kissing the mayor's ring. So I'll say something else.
Well, you know, I will say this, you know, I don't know how many people are here, 25, 30 maybe. For a subject as important as water is, you were asking what you can do. You know, one of the pieces politically here is that this is not a lot of people. People here may be intense in their feelings, but it's not a lot of people. And if you have neighbors and can encourage them to, either because they don't know about it or, you know, they think it'll just fix itself, if you can get them involved, that would be helpful.
Jim, you've been here long enough, and Ron knows this, I know this, Jim Harrell standing right there knows this. Until either the water doesn't drip out of the faucet or brown water flows out of the faucet, 98% of the people in this county are going to say, I don't really give a damn.
Yeah.
You know, that's the only thing that will wake people up, is when actually it is something that directly, immeasurably affects them. Otherwise, you know, they don't care. They don't know what's going on.
That's how the mayor's been able to get by with all this disproportionate money all these years, just because the voters don't get involved and don't care that much about it.
Well, I again have to stand on what I said. I personally have to operate in good faith.
I agree with you, Jim. I'm nothing but supportive of what you're doing. I'm not being critical at all. I think you're doing a great job at tremendous odds against me.
What do we do now,
I don't know.
Team leader?
Team leader.
Storm the city hall?
All we can do is get the word out there to the rest of the citizens. I mean, they're all going to find out starting next month.
We got a thumbs up there.
They're all going to find out what's going on next month when they start getting their water bill. So, I mean, that's really, unfortunately, that's the only thing that wakes people up, is when it starts hitting them in the pocket.
Yeah, they'll go, what's this about?
I didn't see the mayor. See, my thing is the mayor knows that too well, and he panic.
Well, I hope you're right, but we still need an agreement, is the problem. Even if he doesn't let that happen, we need to get
outlined. There's going to be these white angels that come to Brian Sam and Patrick Bell in the 11th
hour. I think the unfortunate thing, truly, though, is someone who can credibly and will threaten to turn off the water as a negotiation tactic. To me, that is not good faith.
Yeah, I agree with that.
No, absolutely. No.
Well, Mary, I never had anything in good faith, in my view. All the stuff I've been involved with between the city and the county over all these years, he's never done anything in good faith. Never.
How old is he?
He will be 71 in December.
Health-wise.
And he's been mayor for
40 some odd years. 42 years, 43 years, something like that.
So, I mean, he has all his faculties.
And most of the members of the city council have been there for, you know, 25 plus years as well.
Yeah.
That's a good old building.
Yeah.
Yep.
Well, it's interesting, if you ever go to a city hall meeting, it's interesting to watch the voting, because the mayor will call for a vote. He sits in the middle. Everybody's off to the sides, right? He calls for a vote. He's looking down at his papers. He says, everybody who agrees, raise your right hand, or raise your hand. He's not even looking. He doesn't even look at see how they vote. And he says, unanimous. I mean, the eyes have it, it's unanimous.
It gives you the impression they might have a pre-meeting.
I didn't even think he did everything behind closed doors, too, so you can actually...
Well, who knows what goes on, you know, like Ron? Yeah, like Ron was saying, who knows what goes on before their meetings? But even their meetings are just rubber stamp. I mean, there's never conversation, there's never the same vote.
And even if they open the floor and somebody brings something, goes, well, where were you earlier? We've had three meetings and you weren't there, so basically I'm going to discount what you're saying now because you haven't been involved from the beginning. Well, I'm here now.
They also changed their rules so that you basically can't stand up and do public comments at the city council meetings anymore either. I mean, Brant Meadows and I showed up one day. We had to send in a request like by noon that day, and we got up to speak, but the next day they changed the rules, so you couldn't do that anymore.
Is that right?
Yeah, it was amazing. It was quite amazing. So
this was at a meeting where you could? As long as you signed up as you could enter?
I had to send a request to the
the meeting that I was at where this happened? You signed up like the hour before the meeting, and then they called your name and had to come up and speak, but then they discounted everybody who spoke.
Right.
It's like, what's that? Then what's the point?
No, it's an interesting process.
So what would it do to the schools that need all this water and stuff too? I mean, that just, wow.
Any school that's in District 2 and 4.
That's a very good question.
How scary is
that? I think Charlie's right.
Can you imagine if you don't have the water pressure and they need to flush the toilets in like the high schools and stuff?
He may be crazy, but he's not insane.
But he's not dumb.
Yeah, he's not insane. He's not going to turn the water off.
He's pretty clever.
Yeah, but it's still going
to
affect
him. He's using this as a negotiating tactic, and we just need to make sure that we don't cave in. It's kind of threat. It's blackmail,
that's
what it is.
It is.
As far as I'm concerned. It is. It is blackmail.
Actually, it's extortion.
Well, if we have to pay the higher rates, it will be extortion. That's correct. I agree with that.
Both apply, I think.
Wow.
So,
well, I congratulate you for getting us out here today.
Well, I'm a little disappointed we didn't have more folks here, but
I am too. But I never, I didn't expect
to thank each and every one of you for coming out today to support this and understand how important it is. So, you know, if you each tell 10 people and they tell 10 people, then maybe we can really start making a business.
We can start a multi-level water business.
That'd be good.
Jen, I don't know how many of you know Nydia Tisdale. Nydia's the owner of the About Forsyth website, and she is also the young lady that was thrown out of the city council meeting for trying to videotape one of the mayor's meetings and filed.
Good for you, public meeting.
And she filed a complaint with the state attorney general against the mayor, which is still pending. So.
There have been two lawsuits filed against the city. It's just too bad you didn't go, oh, my leg!
Thanks, everybody, for coming.
Sure.
I got a picture of you putting up a sign.
I hope you didn't get it
out of it. Don't be disheartened.
I know, it's hard not to.
Well, I hear you. I hear you.
I already told Tim Perkins, you better be prepared in October. You're going to have people storm the county admin.
learn this and you ain't learning.
So I'm trying to be proactive. And then, of course, you know, working towards those on a, I am a